Welcome everybody to another stream here on our Easy Encore channel on Mixer.com. My name is Rav. I will be host for you this session where we talk about Introduction to Microsoft 365. This is a phenomenal update or a new change for what Office 365 has been for quite some time. And we'll be talking a little bit about Microsoft 365. So I'm just going to make sure that I can see you guys in the chat, making sure that you guys are logged in there. And then that way I can go ahead and answer any questions if you guys have them there as we're kind of going through this session. We'll get started in a moment. So again, just a couple of reminders for you guys that are tuning in for this session. If you guys want to interact with myself throughout the session, if you have any questions, feel free to make sure you're logged into Mixer.com, and then that way you will be able to access this chat there. Ask me any questions. If you need me to slow down on something, if you need me to emphasize something a little bit more, spend a little bit more time somewhere, then that way we can go ahead and talk about that. I do want to remind everybody, for everybody that's tuning in, we are doing some giveaways throughout the week. I have the little message around there, and you can see it in the name. We are actually doing some giveaways every 100 different followers. So we're giving an $80 Xbox gift card code, also we're going to be doing an easy trivia stream Friday at 2 p.m. And that easy trivia stream is going to have questions related to a lot of the streams that we did throughout the week. And we're giving some hints away as you're watching these streams. So you have a reason to go back. We record these and you can go back through our channel, watch some of these videos, get some hints at some of those questions. So it's a great way to get prepared and have that opportunity to set yourself up to win another $80 code there. So some giveaways happening. If you want to set yourself up, stay tuned. I'll be giving some hints as well throughout the stream in terms of what types of questions you guys might get asked when it comes to Microsoft 365 during the Easy Trivia at 2 p.m. on Friday. All right, so let's get things started here, and let's talk about Microsoft 365 and what the agenda for today is going to be. So we're going to kick things off of what is Microsoft 365 and why the name change. So from Office 365 to Microsoft 365, what's really happening here, what's going on about that. Then we'll talk about what's going to be included as a part of Microsoft 365, some existing features, but also talking about some of those new features that are coming to Microsoft 365. And then I definitely wanted to showcase some demos, some highlights, some key features that can really make your life a little bit more productive, a little bit more protective with the enhanced security, and also a little bit more creative as well with some new features that are coming with Microsoft 365. So I'll be showcasing some of those demos to you guys today, so you guys have a better understanding of how you guys can use these tools for yourselves. And last but not least, we will finish off with the value of Microsoft 365 and how you'll be able to take advantage of Microsoft 365 and kind of how it really deep dives in terms of the value that is available to you. So let's kick things off and get started with what is Microsoft 365. And I have this video that's just playing over to the side of me here that's kind of giving you some quick tidbits of some of the features that are there, but it's not really explaining it, but that's okay. I will be highlighting and showcasing some of these features as we kind of go along. All right, so here we go. In terms of what Microsoft 365 is, many of us, we're working and we're doing a lot of stuff. We're managing and balancing so many things in our lives. We got work, we got everything that's going on at home. We have all our personal favorite things, like our hobbies and interests that we have. There might be the kids. There's just so much to juggle. And we're acutely aware of all the different ways that life can interrupt work, and then work can also interrupt life. It's never been more important to make sure that we're staying connected on top of the things that really do matter. So, they're not just meshing all together and you're not feeling like, hey, I didn't really get to spend some time on the things I wanted to, or my work is taking a hit because all these other things are kind of holding me back. So it's about finding all the right tools to make sure that you're being the best you that you can be. And Microsoft 365 is really going to accentuate that. So Microsoft 365 was introduced about 2 weeks ago. What essentially is happening is Office 365 is now becoming Microsoft 365. So if you already have Office 365, you already have a subscription, you've been on there for some time, it is now going to go ahead and, you know, without any charge or any cost, it's going to be Microsoft 365 for you. And it's not just a new name. There's actually a lot more that's happening there. You're going to be getting more benefits all around for the same price, so there's absolutely no extra charges for this. But hey, if you're not on Office 365, this is going to be the perfect opportunity to learn a little bit more of why this is going to be useful for you. It's literally the subscription to, you know, help your life and make the most of your time getting connected, protecting the ones you love, and to develop and grow. So one thing I could say, if you want to take away from this whole change that's happening, is that there is a new name, but you're getting more benefits for the same price. So new name, more benefits, same price. And that's phenomenal, where you're getting more for not paying anything extra, right? So before we really jump into Microsoft 365, though, Office has been for a while, been out there for a while, right? You know, it's been out there for ages, and then Office 365 has come out starting in 2011. It's a service that, you know, we all know and love. We've always been saying every device needs Office, so, you know, Office 365 has been that perfect solution for you if that's what you've been using. Since 2011, newer features have been added on. So, for example, in 2014, OneDrive was added on, so OneDrive cloud storage. They added on 1 terabyte per user available on Office 365, which is phenomenal value, even if you're just looking to pick it up just for the online storage available to you. And then beyond that, you know, as Office 365 was growing, it's added on more and more features. And now with the addition of the new amazing features on Microsoft 365 that'll make your life more creative, organized, and secure, it just made sense for Office 365 to go ahead and take that next step in evolution and actually become Microsoft 365. So it was a perfect opportunity not only to, you know, change what it is, it's because it's changed so much over the years, it just kind of made sense. As something keeps evolving and offering more benefits, it just becomes necessary to change what it actually is, essentially. There's some phenomenal features that we're going to be talking about today. So for example, they added on some new premium templates and content, which can help your family get a little bit more creative in anything you want to build together or for your work. Maybe it's new book reports, building out birthday cards. We're going to be showcasing some of these templates and stuff today and show you what the difference is. There's also going to be a new family safety app. With the new family safety app, you're going to be able to stay connected with your loved ones through location sharing. There's also technical support that's being added in. You know, so it's there for you whenever you need it. Whenever you have any issues, that's going to be able to help you out. And you know, with all these additions, the name change just really honestly made sense. It just made sense with all these new additions after so long, you know, almost a decade, to go ahead and change that over to Microsoft 365. And it's not just because it's focusing on productivity features now. There's features there to help you in so many other parts of your life there. So let's kick things off and let's look at some of these features and some of these key things and what's different, what's new, what's happening there. So let's start off with what's already going to be included as a part of Microsoft 365. Like, what's carrying over from Office 365 and what are some of those things that you already love and you love to use? Well, number one, you got dictation. So dictation is an amazing feature that's already available as a part of your Premium Office app. So the Premium Office applications are already going to be included as a part of Microsoft 365. So your Word, Excel, PowerPoint, they're all going to be getting new features, but they're still going to carry over those amazing features that are going to be there. So you have dictation, intelligent inking. You know, there's a number of people on our team that absolutely love the intelligent inking. What they're doing is they're taking something like their Surface Pen, and they're able to take those notes on OneNote or draw or add anything to their Word or whatever it is. You have that inking capability across Office. There's language and proofing packs. There's the real-time collaboration as well. So if you're working on the same type of projects with somebody else, it makes sense to have that real-time collaboration to work on it rather than, hey, here's my part. Then you have to email it to them. Then they have to add their parts. And then you have to still try to make it look like it's all nice and all together. So it's definitely a little bit harder to go back from real-time collaboration once you've kind of started that. So definitely is something you want to look into if you haven't already when it comes to that. But let's talk about some of the new stuff here, all right? So in terms of new stuff, there's going to be new premium templates that are added on as a part of Microsoft 365. So in terms of premium templates, we're looking at over 2,300 templates now available that are added, and these are premium templates. And then you got premium creative content, over 8,000 images, 175 looping videos and 300 fonts and 2,800 icons. That's a ton of content. So if you're a person that already, spends some time maybe picking up subscriptions that you need stock photography for, maybe you need it for your line of business or whatever you do, and you need to pay for those extra services to pull that in and actually go ahead and use that, this is a perfect opportunity where you could save yourself some money and have Microsoft 365, and it's already included as a part of the subscription from Microsoft 365. It's a ton of content there. Over 2,300 templates, 8,000 images in terms of created content, 175 looping videos, 300 fonts, 2,800 icons. Now, I could sit here and obviously talk to you about all this, but I'd rather show it to you. So let's go on, showcase some of these premium content and templates and stuff like that. So I'm just going to go ahead, minimize that for now. And let's kick things off in PowerPoint. PowerPoint's a great place where you're getting creative, you're trying to showcase and highlight a lot of things. So let's take a look at some of these premium templates and a lot of the creative content as a part of this. So here I have my PowerPoint open. All right, I'm already logged in. I got my information logged in there. I'm going to go ahead and click New. And as soon as you click New, this is where it's already giving you some of those templates that have been there for some time. But now you're going to start seeing those premium templates actually show up there as well. So if I go ahead and take a look at some of these down here, these are some of the ones that I've seen for some time, you know, usually pretty standard, and that's what the templates look like. But if you are a Microsoft 365 subscriber, it is also going to showcase to you some of these premium templates, like, you know, you got some here with the tomatoes, you got, you know, this one with the dog, you got one with the integer pillars. And these aren't the only ones, though. Like I said, there's over 2,300. So to really narrow down which one is the right one for you, what you probably want to do is go to the search and find what type of content or PowerPoint you want to build, and then from there be able to help put together that presentation. So, for example, if it's just presentations I want to put together, then I'm going to go ahead, click on presentations, and then as I'm just selecting the presentation there, this is where I'll have that opportunity to go ahead and really narrow down to what I want to build out. So there's these great premium templates that I'm already seeing here. So you're getting some updated stuff. There's a lot of ones with a lot of images. Looks like there's a lot of details here as well in terms of being able to build out these better presentations. So it kind of makes sense for you to be able to go ahead and select one of these and use it for your presentation. But if you want to narrow down even more, use that search to your advantage and go ahead and do that. So let's go through an example of what we would be essentially doing here if we wanted to go ahead and start a presentation. And personally, I've been looking forward to a vacation for quite some time. I know we're kind of all stuck indoors a little bit, but this is that perfect opportunity where we could go ahead and, you know, maybe look to the future. It's like, hey, once, you know, everything goes back to normal, and it's going to be sooner rather than later, we're going to be able to go ahead and maybe prep for a vacation. So maybe you want to put together a little deck or a vacation deck for your family to showcase, hey, I want to pitch an idea for vacation. Let's all get together. Let's go out there. I really want to go, right? So let's do this. So this is where I could go ahead and type in vacation. And then from here, I'm going to be able to go ahead and now find different types of layouts that I could use in terms of vacation. So here's one called Fun Vacation Presentation. I've used this one already a couple times. This is one of the new premium template ones. Looks phenomenal. So I'm going to go ahead and actually go ahead and select that. And then we're going to go through like what it means to be a premium template and what kind of options that you actually are going to have available for yourself. So if we're looking at this template over here, this is where it's automatically telling you, hey, you got this template, but there's some things that you might not be able to edit. And the reason why you might not be able to edit this stuff is simply because of the way that everything is kind of set up here. So if you do need to edit some of the stuff, it's giving you some pointers and some tips in terms of how to go about actually using that to go ahead and access this template here. So you have that capability of going in and using and editing all that stuff. So I'm going to go ahead and click close. And let's take a look at this this deck here, this premium template. So you got some phenomenal images. I mean, this image already looks amazing to me. And with that, you're actually able to go ahead and highlight whatever it is that you want to showcase. So maybe you want to go to Disney World. Maybe you want to hit up a couple beaches and you really want to get that point across. Like, hey, we could be here. So use some of these templates to really highlight that. Here's another one that's Divider Slide. With Divider Slide, you know, it really gives you a nice shot, picturesque opportunity here to really go in and take a look at how you can situate your information and your images. You got another one here with the text layout, accentuating information there, and the colors are great as well. So with this, you're getting something that looks like, you know, something a marketing company might put together. If they're trying to pitch an idea for like a getaway for a team or whatever it is, this is the type of deck that you get. And to be honest, there's not a lot of work you need to do here. And that's because Designer and some of the premium content is going to help you fill in those gaps. And I'll show you that in a second. But you can see these different layouts here. It's giving you something of everything just to give you an example of what they look like. You got a comparison slide here. You also have a chart slide. You know, if you want to throw in a pie graph, because, you know, pie graphs are awesome and maybe they'll help you get your point across. Well, that's essentially the way to do it. That's the way that you're going to be able to figure out how to, you know, really message, let people know, hey, I'm trying to get my message across here, and this is how I'm going to be able to do it. And this is how essentially you would be able to do it. So great opportunity that you have available to do that. You got your table slide. Let's be honest, budgeting. Budgeting is always something you want to consider. I see Lobo Grand 69 said, pie. Yeah, I would, to be honest, I would take a picture of a pie and toss it into the slide, because that's just me. I want to get it across. Hey, pie charts are great, but pie is also so much better. I love me a nice, good apple pie. So that's probably something you want to toss in there. Budgeting is always a concern, so maybe you want to go ahead and you know, budget for your trip there. So this is that perfect opportunity that you're going to be able to go ahead and budget for what you want to do. So you are going to have that opportunity to go ahead and showcase this budget to your family. It's like, hey, I'm putting together this slideshow, and here's where the money is going to be going. So if it's Disney World, maybe this is how much we're going to spend. We can all budget it. You'll get your point across so much better. This is the sweet one. This is your big image there. And with that big image, you're going to be able to really highlight all the different things that you can showcase, especially for your trip. So with the big image, that's the one that I would love to showcase. Hey, if I'm planning a trip to the beach, if I'm planning a trip anywhere I like, I'll be able to go ahead and showcase this on this big image slide. So let's take a look at how we can customize these slides now, because I did talk to you guys a little bit about the premium content. So how we can use that premium content now to be able to customize these slides to our liking, and what content you are actually getting there now. So let's go ahead and click on at the top here. So you're going to see it says insert. And here's where some of the premium content comes in. So again, there's over 8,000 images, 175 looping videos, and 300 fonts and 2,800 icons that have now been included as a part of this, you know, the feature set for Microsoft 365. So we're going to go ahead and click pictures. And stock images is where that a lot of that content is going to help you out in, especially if you want to toss it in. So maybe it's a trip out to the beach. I don't know. Where do you guys like to go on trips? If you guys want to shoot that in the message, maybe we can put together a slide for that. Until then, I'll try to find a nice picture of the beach. But if there's somewhere that you guys absolutely love to go and love to visit, I'd love to hear it. And maybe we can talk a little bit about that and toss that in there as well. So let's say it's the beach that you want to go to. So I can easily go in and type in beach. And the photos that I'm going to get here are not just your standard photos that you're pulling off from the internet. There's actually a lot of stock photography that is now available to you. Like I said, over 8,000 images that are now included. And now you'll have that availability of using that to your advantage to build out more creative presentations here. So, and these are some phenomenal images that I'm already seeing in terms of, you know, what's out there, what's kind of included. And when I type in the beach, you know, some of them really stand out and highlight. So I like this one here with, you got your palm trees here, you got the beach and the sand there. So maybe we want to go ahead and hit that one. And now you can see I kind of overlaid this on top here, but automatically it's actually going ahead and taking another step where it is now overlaying on top of my slides, and Designer is opened up. And with Designer, it's actually going ahead and letting me know that I can you know, change the slide up the way I want based on that premium template. I don't need to put the work in here. Designer is actually going to do that for me. So, you know, for students that are building out PowerPoint presentations for their projects, you know, for people that are working away and need to do presentations for work, this is where Designer really helps you out. This is another feature as a part of Microsoft 365. On the side here, I can just click on any one of these. And you can see my whole slide, just like the ones that we looked through, it is taking me through step by step and being able to change out those slides for me. So super, super easy for now for me to be able to go in and actually go ahead and update any of this stuff. So I'm actually able to select whichever one I want to go for, whatever view I want to go for. So, you know, I like something with that big picture image. So maybe I want to build the slides a similar way. Now it's done. Now I'm ready to go. I can see the beach here, and if I want to add a message, add some text, I can do that. And Designer is going to help me save that time for being able to do that. And it's not just on this slide. I could change up a variety of other slides. So there's this one here, but since Designer is open, I can go back and change this whole slide over. Instead of me moving things around, move items around, I can just go ahead and click wherever I want. And now it's changing the text, it's changing the design, it's changing whatever it is, and makes it super easy for me to be able to do that. So this is where Microsoft 365 is actually showcasing extra features to you, extra benefits, that what you'll have available, especially if you need to put together a PowerPoint. You have these amazing design ideas there. You have this, you know, the premium content there now. And I'll showcase a little bit more on that premium content side. Whatever it is that you want to add in, you know, if I go back and click, let's say I want to insert a new slide, and then I want to insert another image. So I go to pictures, stock images. There's a wide variety of topics that you can see at the top here as well. So as I'm going across the top, you can see all the different ones that are there. So depending on what I'm looking for, you can just type in to get some ideas there. But I do encourage that you guys actually go ahead, type in the actual topic that you want to type in, and then from there you'll be able to see that as well. So it makes it interesting and a great way for you to do that. So that there's your stock images. So like I mentioned, a lot of premium content that is now going to be available for you with Microsoft 365. So let's keep it going. Instead of PowerPoint, what about Word, right? What about Word? How is there some new features, or how can I use these premium templates in Word in terms of the stuff I'm doing? So let's go over to Word here. So on Word, you still have those premium templates available to you when I click on New, and you're gonna start seeing some of those start popping up. So some of them are the normal templates that you've seen from Time, but now you're actually gonna have availability to see some of these more premium templates that are available. So over 2,300 templates, these are across Word, PowerPoint, Excel, and then from here, you're going to be able to go ahead and select anything that you like. So if you're in business and you wanna create maybe a document or whatever it is that you wanna put together, this template is gonna go ahead and help you out with whatever it is. So you're gonna be able to go ahead, click on that template and find whatever it is you wanna build. Maybe it's an agreement here. It's already put together as some sample agreements for you there. Maybe it's a restaurant brochure. It's giving you those premium templates to build out that brochure if you wanted to. Now, if you're an educator, same thing goes there. So you can click on education, and then from education, you have that capability of finding things that will help you build out and save you so much time when you're looking at things that you would want to build out for education. So maybe it's a brochure that you want to put together for school, a college newsletter. Maybe it's some minutes from a meeting that you had there. There's a ton of cool stuff that you could actually use for your advantages. Teacher appreciation card. You know, you always want to put together a digital card there, and you want to do that. Then this is that great opportunity for you to be able to do that here as well. So a great way to look into that. Another thing that you could look into. Just a reminder for everybody, Sunday's coming up, it's Mother's Day, so maybe you want to put together and do something for Mother's Day, right? So it's the perfect idea to put in Mother's Day and hit search, and now you got these beautiful templates that are available to you as a part of Microsoft 365 that you could go in, edit them. A lot of the work is done for you, but you're going in and customizing them, maybe tossing in a picture, maybe editing the text there that's available for you to make it more unique and interesting to you. So you're going to have that capability of going ahead and being able to do that. So easy way of you getting these premium templates and adding a little bit more creativity to your lives. So I'm going to go ahead and click on flyers. And the reason is I absolutely love these flyers and the premium side of them. Like there's some beautiful work that's already done, and it's super easy for you to now be able to go in, and if you need to put together a quick flyer for whatever it is, these templates are going to be able to help you to do that. So I'll give you an example. If we're looking at movie night, so movie theaters are closed, you can't really go out, but maybe you're missing the whole theme and atmosphere of going out to the movies. You got an option here to set up a movie night with your friends, with your family, whoever you like. Go ahead and just launch into one of these templates. So I'm going to go ahead with the movie night one. And maybe you can make an event out of it. So go ahead, put down a date, put down event time, put down that place, shoot it out to your friends and family and say, hey, maybe on Sunday night, let's all get together and let's watch a movie. Let's make an event out of it. We'll hop on a Teams call in advance, do some video conferencing, and we'll spend like, you know, 15, 20 minutes talking about, you know, the movie or what we're expecting from the movie. Sort of like if you went out to dinner and you're talking about the movie beforehand. And then you could shoot this flyer out to them, and then you could do the whole, hey, after the movie's done, let's have a chat about the movie and what we thought about it. So you can make it a whole event as is, and just to have some fun, use some of these templates. And again, you can customize this. You still have that premium content available to you. So I go to insert. So I'm going to go ahead and click here, insert pictures, stock images, and you have the stock images there. So keep in mind, stock images, right? A lot of people, magazines, you know, digital creators, whoever it is, they tend to pay for these services out there that take a monthly fee just so you can access stock images. Stock images, you know, images of cutout people. So check out these cutout people here. You got, you know, phenomenal options. These are now included as standard on Microsoft 365. So there's actually, you know, you don't need to actually go ahead out of your way to pay for you know, this stock imagery. So if you need it to build a flyer for your business, if you need it to emphasize something or make a social media post, you are now gonna have this content available to you with Microsoft 365. So it's a great way to go in, and you can select anybody here, and then you'll be able to go ahead and click on them and see them in a variety of different you know, poses or whatever it is, depending on what you want to use them for. You will be able to do that directly from here. So, and no matter who you're clicking, you're going to see them in the variety of different poses that are now available to you. So let's say, for example, I want to go ahead and then for movie night on this poster here, I want to go ahead and add somebody there. I can click on somebody, click insert, and now you can customize it a little bit. Maybe you want to toss in your own image to make it a little bit unique, but essentially I'm able to go ahead, change some settings here, add somebody, make them look like they're on the red carpet for movie night, and maybe you want to get this out there and work that way. So with premium templates, with the new premium content, you have that available to you with Microsoft 365. If you're already on Office 365, you're going to move over to Microsoft 365 for free. There's no extra charges, but you're getting all these features now included. So it's just something I wanted to showcase. There's still a ton of other great features there as well. So if you're a person that is looking to update your resume, Resume Assistant is still going to be there. So if I click on New and maybe I go to Resumes and Cover Letters and just open up a random one up here. So let's say here's a resume. As soon as you open this up, there's the Resume Assistant feature that is going to pop up, and you can see it on the side, and you can search for it at the top and you'll find it. And what Resume Assistant does is, based on what you write in your resume, it's going to go ahead, you type in those settings, and it will help you build a better resume. It will search and connect to LinkedIn, whatever title you put in. So if you, like myself, I put in senior trainer, it's going to say, okay, senior trainer, and this is where I can find information directly connected to LinkedIn to update my resume that way. Makes it super easy. If I type in, you know, manager, it's a little bit more generic, but maybe sales manager, project manager, whatever it is, assistant manager. If I click on that, now it's going to go ahead and actually find me the information there for assistant managers and what they've posted on LinkedIn. So if you need a little help in terms of, hey, what kind of things should I be writing on my resume? Resume Assistant is going to help you do that. It makes it super easy for you to go ahead and use the Resume Assistant to get it updated, rather than trying to figure out, hey, what do I put on my resume? What will make my resume sound a little bit better? This is where Resume Assistant comes in on Word, and it's going to help you build that out by pulling information from LinkedIn. So this is another amazing feature of Microsoft 365 that is included now as well. So it's been there on Office 365, is still going to be there for you when you need it here. But let's keep things moving here. Another feature I wanted to showcase is Editor. So everybody wants to be a better writer. You know, grammar check, spell check, that's been out there for ages. So how do you become a better editor? Well, there's a new feature called Editor that has been introduced on Microsoft 365. So with Editor, you're going to be able to go in and do so much more other than just editing for grammar checks and spell checks. To showcase that to you guys, I'm going to highlight and go over to a document that I already had open. So I'm going to go to my browser. And this is a sample document. It's just a random sample document that I was given for demoing purposes and stuff like that. I didn't really write this. But, you know, it sounds like there was a lot of work put into it, But now this new editor feature is just showing up at the top right corner. So when I click on editor, I'm going to be able to see a lot more that I can do to build up my work here. So I click on editor. And here it's automatically going to, you can see that it's taking the count and starting to count up some things that I can do to become a better writer. So, and this is a new feature that's not just available on Word. It's going to be available for Outlook. So if you're a person that emails a lot, it's going to be available as an extension on your Microsoft Edge or Chrome browsers. And that's going to allow you to become a better writer in all your social media, in forums, online, wherever you like. This is going to be able to run that for you to become to allow you to become a better writer there. So you're going to have that option available to you to help you out with that. So let's take a look at what it actually does. So one, you got your corrections here and your refinements. So your corrections are those same things that you've seen from time. You got your spelling, you got your grammar. So with spelling, it's just going to outright click on that, and it's going to tell you, hey, there's some mistakes here. You got to change that up. So, you know, in theory, if every country, Gret and Smollett, well, that's got to be great. So you go ahead and click on that, and now it's counted down. Now it knows, hey, you've already made that correction. You're looking good. And there's some spelling here with some spacing, so it's making sure the spacing is accurate as well. So we're going to go ahead and click on that, and now that's corrected that as well. Now let's take a look at some grammar. So, you know, it's just telling you, hey, stocks, maybe you want to put a comma there. And this one, it shouldn't be affect, it should be effect. So we're going to go ahead and click on that. And then protection end. That, forget the comma, it's telling me that this should be this way. There we go. So that's something that has been there for some time. You know, the grammar check, the spell check. This is where making a writer really comes in better. This is where the refinements come in. And again, this is based on your own decisions on how you want to write, but it's giving you some ideas of how to become that better writer. So you have clarity. So with clarity, what it's essentially doing is clearing up how you are writing your writing. So in this case, this was a paper on IGOs, I believe. Yeah, role of IGOs. Now, in some cases, you know, you writing a little bit more sophisticated is good, depending on who your audience is. But what clarity helps you do is that it's telling you that a simpler word here would be clearer for your reader. It's trying to gauge your most average reader and how simplifying some of your writing is going to help your paper, your research paper, whatever it is you're writing, your post or online or whatever, to make it a little bit clearer for more people to understand. It's going to give you those clarity suggestions. So here it's saying instead of numerous, use many. All right. Instead of benefit, use help. Instead of be lost, well, it's saying no suggestions there. But maybe you want to look into that and saying, hey, I want to suggest something for you there. So I'm going to click ignore on that one. But you can see that there are options that are available for you in terms of clarifying your writing. In terms of conciseness, well, facilitate. It's saying instead of seemingly facilitate, so it's like, hey, just say facilitate. It makes it so much easier. It's a little bit more clear. Go with that option. So that's what we're going to do. Then you have conciseness here. Again, perhaps in. Maybe you just want to use the word in, right? So with conciseness, what it's trying to do is actually narrow down the more words you're using to bring down that count a little bit lower, just so it's a little bit easier for the reader to read. Now, if you're a student, you might not like that. And that's because some of your teachers might say, hey, there's a word count. You need to have this many certain words that are need to be used, essentially. So that's where you need to make sure that there's some clarification there. And that's where the conciseness comes in. But in some cases, hey, I do want to clarify. I want this to be an easier read for whoever it is, and I can go ahead and go through that. So corn in particular, I can just say corn, right? Stocks, corn, etc. So go through that. Use that tool to your advantage. Formality is another thing. So don't use do not. Instead of clearly we, you could just capitalize the we and start that way. This is helping you make a better all-around, well-rounded paper. You got your punctuation conventions. You got also set sensitive geopolitical references. It's looking into that as well, and then vocabulary as well. So inclusiveness was another one, making sure that your paper is inclusive, making sure whatever you're writing is inclusive as well. So, and at the end, you're going to get some stats. It's going to tell you, hey, it's going to take you 5 minutes to read the whole paper that you just wrote. It's going to take 8 minutes for you to speak there as well. So this is where you have that opportunity for you to go ahead and understand better how your writing is. You also have the readability score. So this is based off the Flesch Reading E score. Having a score higher than 60 makes your writing a little bit more easier to understand. So that's the score you want to essentially go for. So we're at 36 about here. It's a little bit more of a complicated topic, and that's why it's a little bit lower, but we could do some things to mitigate that, increase that. And it's also giving me the distinct level of words, letting me know how my vocabulary is. Do I need to improve that? Do I need to decrease from that? This is where I have that option available for me to go in and check to see how my vocabulary is doing. So this is a great new feature with Editor. It's going to make you a better writer. It's available for Word. And as I mentioned, it's also going to be available on your Outlook. So if you want to write better emails and make sure all that stuff is sounding great, it's going to be there. And also if you want to just become a better writer altogether in your browsing or online, then you download the editor extension. It's going to be available for you as well on Microsoft Edge and the Chrome browser. So then it's going to help you out with that. I just got a little video here that I'm going to just quickly play. It showcases some of the features and the different ways that you can actually showcase and use Editor. So let's go ahead and play that. Sorry, forgot to unmute the mic there. Thank you very much, Lobo Brand, for that there. I was just going to say that was a great video. It really kind of highlights and showcases the different features of Editor and all the different areas. But next, I wanted to actually talk about more features and talking about PowerPoint and how you can become a better presenter altogether. So there is a feature called Presenter Coach that I wanted to demo to you guys to help you guys become better presenters. So if that's something you're struggling with and you need some help and you're tired of asking your siblings, you're a little bit tired of asking the next person over or your mom or whoever it is or your buddy saying, hey, I got to do this presentation. Could you hear me practice? Could you listen to me practicing my presentation? And sometimes, you know, they might say, sure, we'll listen in. And sometimes, you know, if it's a sibling or whatever, it's like, nah, I don't got time, or they're going to be a little bit harsh on you or not. So they might listen in. But Presenter Coach is actually going to be able to make you a better presenter altogether. And this is another feature of Microsoft 365. So let's go ahead and I'm going to showcase how this feature works. So here's a sample presentation that I've presented in the past. I've done this on a stage at a large scale event that we had back here in Toronto last year. But this is where I'm going to use an example. So I'm not going to talk about the presentation itself, but I'm going to showcase how this feature works. So this feature is called Presenter Coach. It's available on Microsoft 365 on the online version. So you just have the presentation ready to go. And then you can just go over to Slideshow. And then when you click on Slideshow, you're going to have Rehearse with Coach here. So Rehearse with Coach is that button where it's going to use this coach, and this presenter coach is actually going to actively listen in on you presenting and then give you instant feedback and also more subjective feedback with information at the end of the presentation as well. So let's dive in and let me show you how this actually works out. So here's my presentation. I'm ready to go. I would just go ahead and click on Rehearse with Coach. And now what you can see here, here's my presentation. I'm full screen. I'm about to, you know, prepare here. On the right-hand side is telling me, hey, welcome to PowerPoint Presenter Coach. As you rehearse, we'll give you feedback about how you're presenting. At the end, you'll see a numerical summary and our suggestions. So here's where it's going to be letting me know. Here's where that information is going to be coming in and something you can look into in terms of getting a better understanding of how to become a better presenter. So I'm going to go ahead and click Start Rehearsing. And I've checkmarked the live feedback. So here it said start presenting, and we will give you that feedback there. So here it's already saying your pace is a little bit slow. Maybe you want to speed up the pace in terms of how you're speaking. So then that way it's a little bit more interesting there. So it's saying, and now it's saying I'm speaking too fast. So talk a little bit slower. So based on that feedback, you will have a better understanding. So let's carry through and let's see what are the things that this will give me feedback on live. And then I will showcase to you at the end of that. Let's go ahead. So this is a slide that says, what's your potential? And it's saying not to use too many fillers like or ah, or let's see, or on top of that. It's automatically telling me if I'm going to use some of those filler words, it's catching those me saying those filler words. So I just said or let's see, and now it's already picking up on that feedback there. It's going to be able to pick up on my pace, as you saw earlier, so the speed of how I'm talking. If I'm going too slow, if I'm going too fast, it's able to capture that naturally there as well. Another cool thing that it's going to be able to do, and if I read this quote right here, there is no paycheck that can equal the feeling of contentment that comes from being the person you are meant to be, Oprah Winfrey. And it says, try to avoid reading the slides, summarize your key points. So if you're not being original, it will also let you know you're not being original. You're literally reading the slides right from, you know, A to Z. And that's not something that's going to be interesting for whoever's there. It's also giving me good feedback. It's saying good pitch variation. Keep it up. So it's not only about how fast you're going, but it's that pitch, higher or lower. You don't want to be monotone and speaking at one monotone voice because this sounds very robotic. And being robotic is not really interesting because you will really bore out everybody. So that's where you want to actually get that feedback live in terms of how that's happening for you. So in terms of the feedback, in terms of pitch speed, all that cool stuff, it is going to let you know. Try varying your pitch. So there you go. It already picked up that I was kind of spending some time there and not adjusting my pitch. So let's stop this for now, and then I'm going to showcase the report it's going to give you at the end as well. So I'm going to hit escape. And here's the report it's giving you back. So as a coach, it's giving you a lot of information here. So even though you might have gotten, you know, your brother or your sister to listen on your presentation, or your mother, father, significant other, maybe a buddy to listen in, or a colleague or whatever, I'm pretty sure they're not going to give you as detailed feedback as much as rehearsing with coach is going to do, rehearsing with the presenter coach. And the reason is it's literally taking everything in and showcasing you exactly where you need to improve and fix those problems so you can get better at presenting in a certain way. So just to break it down, you got your summary in the top left. So it's saying, hey, 2 minutes and 22 seconds spent, 2 slides were rehearsed. Perfect, great, super easy. So on originality, it's telling me on this slide, on slide 2, I wasn't original. I was actually reading from the slides, and that's where I know I need to go back and I need to adjust some of the stuff. If I'm saying something on that slide, maybe I don't showcase it on the screen if I'm going to say it anyway. In this case, I used a quote. That's okay. You're reading a quote. It makes sense. But at least it's giving you that feedback and letting you know about that, letting you know that it's able to do that. It's also picking up sensitive phrases. So if you're saying anything that's not really inclusive, that might offend somebody, then it's going to be catching that as well and saying, hey, this might offend somebody. Maybe you don't want to include that as a part of your presentation, or maybe you want to reword that in a different way to make you better understanding that. In terms of pace, it's letting me know how many words per minute I'm talking. So I'm in the green. It's telling me 142 words per minute is perfect. That's where I want to be. So great job. Keep it up. It also shows me that average pace over time. So maybe I slow down in a certain area versus somewhere else. So now I'm actually able to see that feedback there as well. Last but not least, I got that pitch. So you want to stay in the target area here where you're varying that pitch and staying a little bit on the higher end. You don't want to go monotone like I did at the end there. And you can see it's a little bit low and it's in the monotone section. It's actually letting me know that my presentation was monotone and you do want to change it up a bit. And last but not least, those fillers. So what are some of the fillers I used? Well, I said, I said, I said, let's see, I said, you know. So these are those fillers that you want to be worried of and how much you're using those fillers. So this will actually let you know, and it's saying, hey, take a pause or take a breath to relax. You don't need to use those fillers. It doesn't really help your presentation. So this is where you're getting live feedback directly from the presenter coach to help you become a better presenter. And that's another feature that is available on Microsoft 365. So if you've already been using Office 365, you're getting this all included. It's been there for some time. On Microsoft 365, you're just getting so much value and so much, it's just so much better there. So that's another reason that, you know, you can really benefit from these additions that are coming with Microsoft 365. Let's carry on there. We talked about Designer a little bit earlier. We talked about some of the other features there. There's going to be more premium templates and stuff that are going to be coming on the Excel side. So if you're a person that is looking at Excel and you're working a lot with Excel, there's going to be some there's some existing features there, like ideas, stock and geography data. There's more premium templates that are going to be available. If you're on OneNote, there's some amazing features on OneNote already, like Ink Replay and Math Assistant. Let me show you a quick one on Math Assistant here. So if I go to my OneNote, if I use something like my Surface Pen, so I already have a formula here, but let me just write another one out. So I'll show you how great the Math Assistant is. If you're having trouble and you need answers for your math formulas, you're trying to solve them, or maybe you're a parent and you want to help your kids with their math homework, perfect option. You got your Surface Pen. You're going to go ahead and write that math formula. So I'm going to go ahead. Maybe it's x plus 3 squared is equal to, let's do 8. So I got my math formula there. And then while I'm in OneNote, there's a feature here in Microsoft 365 called Maths. You can see it at the top here, but before I go ahead and press that button, I'm just going to use the lasso tool at the top left, select everything there, click on Maths, and now you can see it's gone ahead and converted what I wrote down on the screen into a digital format. So I have my my Maths here. I'm going to go ahead and I'm fine with that. There's no mistakes. It's able to pick up my terrible writing now as well. I'm going to click Select Action, Solve for X, and this is where it's actually giving me the answer. So now I have the answer to my mathematical formula, and that's okay, but at the end of the day, I also want to know that I'm also showing the steps. That's what teachers want. They want you to show the steps. So here's where you can find the steps here, and it's actually showcasing step by step. So if you're having some trouble with math, this is where those steps are. This is what you need to do first. This is what you need to do second. This is what you need to do third. And then you can go back and you can also graph it. So instead of graphing and pulling out the pen and paper, here's where that graph is looking like. And this is where I can pull out graph in 2D or both sides in 2D. So now I'm actually looking at that that graph there. And I can insert that on my page and use OneNote to keep track of my notes and stuff. So that's another great feature that's a part of Microsoft 365 that you're getting. And there's a ton of value there as well. But let's talk a little bit about OneDrive. Because OneDrive is something that a lot of people are using now, especially with cloud storage. So let's talk about some of the features that have come to OneDrive and what's included as a part of Microsoft 365 when it comes to OneDrive and what's available for you. So here's my OneDrive here. It's my personal one, so I kind of separated some of my work and I made some folders there. So with OneDrive cloud storage, you're actually on Microsoft 365, you're getting 1 terabyte of cloud storage included per person that is using your Microsoft 365 subscription. The great thing about this is I can access these files from anywhere. These files are living on the OneDrive. I have access to 1.1 terabytes right now, and I could go log into any computer in the world, any phone in the world, and I'll be able to access these files from anywhere. The great thing about this is twofold. One, I have that access instantly. Two, I'm not using up that space on my computer. It's not going to slow down my computer over time. I can access these and work with them wherever I like. So I have that advantage here. That presentation I showcased earlier, it was literally on here. It wasn't on my computer. So I can actually do that and actively work on all this stuff here. Now, beyond this, we've added some other features on OneDrive that are available with Microsoft 365. So Personal Vault. Personal Vault is a great feature where you want extra security in terms of the files that you're putting on your OneDrive. If you just want that extra layer of security, you put them behind the Personal Vault. So what kind of things would you put in there? You could put a copy of your driver license. You could put a copy of your passport. You could put a copy of your insurance papers, a scan of whatever is irrelevant, maybe your SIN card. And you would put it behind there. And the reason is, so now you can access it from wherever you like. And the way that it works is that first, you obviously have to be logged into your OneDrive with your password. But when you do click on it, there's two-step verification. So it needs to either get a text message sent to your phone for you to verify. You can use an authenticator if you want. You can get an email sent and you have to punch in a code again. So you have a wide variety of ways to authenticate, but it's giving you that extra layer of protection. So think about you going on a trip and you lose your passport. That's probably the worst thing ever. You're on a trip, you're in a random country, you lost your passport. Now you got to go to the embassy and explain to them, I lost my passport. How am I going to get back home? you know, you, if you want to speed that process up along, having it in the personal vault locked away, it's going to go a long way. Or even in your insurance papers, maybe you get pulled over and you can't find them in your car for whatever reason. You could go ahead and show that there. There's been a number of times we went to events, people forgot their licenses, but they were okay with you showing the license as a picture or an image. So it was a perfect opportunity there. The next question I get asked is, well, if OneDrive is so secure already, why do you want Personal Vault with more security? Why would you want that? Well, think about your house, right? You lock your front door, and after you lock the front door, everything's safe. Everything's safe in your house, but everybody always takes their those specific documents or specific items, and they still put them in a safe place inside the house. Maybe it's in your bedroom. Maybe it's in the closet somewhere in a safe that's separate that has a keypad or lock or something, or maybe it's a file, binder, or whatever it is. Everybody always takes that extra step because you know that thing is a little extra important. You want to be extra sure that it's going to be secure. It's the same idea with Personal Vault. You're going to have that availability with Personal Vault to going in, scanning these things, and keeping things for you whenever you need them. So it's a great feature to have. Speaking of security, there's also ransomware detection. So anything that you put on here, it will be checked for ransomware to make sure your files are safe and secure. And then you also have the PC folder backup feature. So make a folder on your desktop, have that automatically backed up to your OneDrive. You can automatically keep backing up those files. Not only is your computer keeping them safe and scanning them, but then they'll also be backed up and synced up onto your OneDrive, and you'll have access to that folder whenever you need it on the on that device, but also access to your OneDrive there. So 1 terabyte of storage. You don't need to go out there and buy a laptop with 1 terabyte SSDs nowadays. A lot of people, to be honest, are more than comfortable. I think 70% of people are more than okay with only 128 gigabyte SSD. In case you need a little more, you already have Microsoft 365. It comes with 1 terabyte of storage here. Ton of storage for you to be able to go in and access that. And keep in mind, guys, if you have any questions, throw them in the chat. I'll be able to answer them there live for you guys if you guys do want to do that. And to interact that way, you guys are going to have to, though, log in on Mixer, and then that way I would be able to help you out with that. All right, so that was OneDrive. We're kind of getting close to the end of our session here. It's finishing up at 6, but I did want to highlight some really last quick features. Outlook is getting an update with Microsoft 365, so 50 gigs of inbox. It's going to be ad-free. You're going to be able to use custom email domains if that's something you're interested in as well. There's also going to be support added in. So if you're looking for additional support, Windows 10 support and Microsoft 365 support is now going to be available for you as well. When you're looking into some things that you might need, if you need that extra help, Microsoft 365 support is there, but now Windows 10 support free of charge included as a part of the Microsoft 365 subscription. There's also going to be additional partner benefits available to you as well. So additional offers that are going to be available specifically to those subscribers from Microsoft 365. Partners like Adobe that might be giving offers for their specific types of softwares. You're going to see a bunch of different offers coming in. And then coming soon in the future, we're going to have a number of other applications included. So the first one that was just in this video here a second is going to be Teams. So Teams is going to be included for free as a part of Microsoft 365 for your family, for your friends. It's going to allow you to send messages to everybody, integrate and access, send images, GIFs, files, help you get organized for family events if that's what you're looking to do, have video calls instantly there. So Teams is going to be that app that's going to be included as a part of Microsoft 365 to give you a hand and help you out with that. So it's a great feature that's going to be coming along. If you've already loved it in your workplace, now you're going to have another version available for your family and for your friends. So you have that there. Going back to Outlook, you're going to be able to integrate not only your work calendar, but your personal calendars all in one area on your Outlook. So that's another new feature that's going to be available with Microsoft 365. The last thing I did want to showcase in terms of a new feature that's coming, it's the Family Safety app. So the Family Safety app is going to be a great way for you to be able to go in, set that up on your devices, your family's devices, set up an administrator account, and you'll be able to manage how time is managed across different platforms. So maybe the kids are spending too much time on the computer or on the Xbox or on their Android phone. The app is going to help you go in and you can create that family group. get activity reports on how much time the kids are actually spending on certain things. You can schedule screen time and turn off things and accessibility in certain areas. So you're going to have that. And then you can also have a location finder. So for the kids, you'll know exactly where they are. You can set that up with the family safety app as well. There's a quick little video here that I'm going to quickly showcase that will highlight some of these key features. So let's take a look at that.
So this is the Ellis family. They've all downloaded the app across their mobile phones. And Elliot Ellis at the top here is the family organizer. Now, Microsoft Family Safety is unique in how it helps you manage your family's digital safety across their Xbox, Windows, and Android devices. And right now, these tools are more important than ever because of the amount of time people are spending on these devices. And with Elliot's youngest son home from school right now, he's spending a lot more time engaged in his devices than with his family. So by opening up his son's profile, he can see the total amount of screen time he spent for the day and across specific apps and games. And with this information, they can sit down and have a conversation about, you know, what is the proper amount of time to be spending on this device and how can they help him develop healthier digital habits. And they both agree that they can set a guideline on one of his favorite entertainment apps. And when Elliot selects this app, he can set an app limit that will go across all of his son's devices. And he can choose to set this for a specific time of day or even a different limit depending on if it's a weekday versus a weekend. Now, when his son runs out of time, he'll get a reminder that he's almost out of time and can request more screen time from his parents. And we want to empower kids to be able to ask for that time, but also empower parents to be able to make a choice. And parents also tell us, you know, they want to help their children make the right choices when it comes to content. And looking at the list of apps and games, Elliot's noticed a more mature game pop up to the top that his son has started playing. And with the feature content filters, Elliot can make sure he can set some guardrails for his son that will allow him to ask for approval before downloading an app or a game over a specified age limit from the Xbox or Microsoft store. Yeah, his son is 10 years old, and Elliot had previously set a content filter for 13 and up to give him a little bit of wiggle room, but decides to set it back to 10. Now, with these features, we don't want to create new ways for families to limit their loved ones, but start a dialogue about the type of content that they're engaging in. And parents who are also looking for peace of mind tell us, you know, a lot of that exists on the web too, the websites their kids are accessing. With web and search filters, Elliot can make sure that the internet is a safer place for his kids to explore. He can make Microsoft Edge the default browser, filter out some mature content, turn on safe search, and pre-select some websites that he'll allow his son to visit, and even filter out some websites he maybe doesn't want his son spending some time on. Now, over the course of a week, they both have access to his activity report from the app, and they can see his total screen time across his different devices, across specific apps and games, and even the types of websites he's visiting and some of the terms he's searching for online to really give him the best sense of what's happening in his son's digital world.
All right, so that was a quick video there on the Family Safety app. This one's going to be coming a little bit later on to Microsoft 365, but you can see the level of control that, you know, parents are now going to be able to have with their kids and getting a better understanding of how they're using the internet, but also giving the kids an opportunity to go in and take a look at how they can request some of that time and get a little bit more control in those apps. So in terms of the content, in terms of the safety, in terms of location sharing, there's so much that's happening there. So it's a great app that's going to be adding even more value to your Microsoft 365. The last thing I wanted to talk about, and this is your last opportunity, if you guys have any questions from any of the stuff we talked about, toss them in the chat now and then I'll take a look at them. But the last thing I want to talk about is the value of Microsoft 365. So when we're looking at the cost and what you're getting here, so for Microsoft 365 Personal, this is available for one person. It's going to be $80 a year. But for $80 a year, you're getting all those premium applications with all those features that I showcased. So, you know, your Word, Excel, PowerPoint, OneNote, Outlook, Publisher, Access Teams with, you know, that presenter coach we talked about, the resume assistant that we talked about, the editor that we talked about. Some of those features there alone, they cost, and the premium content as well, right? Some of those things alone cost, you know, $10, $20, $30 a month. Regularly. So if you're looking for stock images, there's subscriptions that people sign up for that. For getting something like an editor to help you with your editing, there's subscriptions that people sign up for that. So this is all encompassing for $79 for the year. Not to mention, on top of that, you get that 1 terabyte of OneDrive storage. That alone kind of, pays for itself in terms of you just getting cloud storage there. So for $79, you're getting a ton of phenomenal value that is there. And then if you want even more value, $109 for the year for six people, And with six people, they're all getting 1 terabyte each of storage online. They're all getting access to all the applications. They're all getting their individual accounts so they can keep their files separate. You're getting a ton of phenomenal value there as well. So tons of value here. $79, that really breaks down to, I think, $667 a month. That's like less than a cup of Starbucks, you know, Frappuccino or some of those fancy drinks. A month. So, you know, if you're looking to get some value and get more productivity, you know, using stuff like that family safety app, getting the 1 terabyte of storage, it goes a long way in terms of being able to put this together. So that kind of wraps up my stream for this session. I did want to highlight, you know, we're going to be doing an easy trivia session at Friday at 2 p.m. I wanted to give a clue for that session if you guys want to know, some of the key features to talk about here. So for Editor, one thing I do want to remind you guys, Editor is also available on the extension on your browser. So there's your little hint there. Editor is also available on Microsoft Edge and Google Chromium as well. Google Chrome, those browsers. So there's your hint. If you guys have been tuning into the session, if you want to get that $80 on the Easier Trivia session at 2 p.m., you're going to have your opportunity available to you there. So thank you very much for tuning in, guys, on this. If there's one thing I could take away again, with Microsoft 365, it is a new name, but you're getting more benefits and same price. I'll be back at 7 o'clock with another session where we'll be talking about the internet, the new Edge browser. So going over all the features of the new Edge browser, why you would want to switch over to it, and what are some of the benefits there and some tips and tricks. So stay tuned for my session at 7 o'clock on that. Thank you very much for joining me again today, and have a good night.